Today's topic is about fractions. We start from the fractions of some shapes. As I have given some geometrical shapes in this video that will help you to understand the concept of fractions easily, and then simplest form of a fraction, then equivalent fraction, and few examples. Here second and third point are very important: simplest form and the equivalent form. Now let's continue. On the screen you can see four circles are given. Now just try to understand the way in which all these circles are divided. Okay, for the first circle, this one, it is divided into two equal parts. Okay, so if we think about the shaded part, shaded means that part is in blue color. Now there are two equal parts, so to write the part of this fraction or the part, this is shaded part, in the form of fraction, we will write numerator and denominators. But what are the values? So in the denominator we will write the total number of parts. As you can see, there are two parts and one shaded part is there, that is in the blue color. So for the shaded part, the fraction is 1 upon 2, that is half. For the second one, I just write half here, okay, so it will be clear to you. So for the second figure, you can see it is divided into 4 equal parts. So the denominator will be 4, and what about the numerator? As the shaded part are 2, so we will write 2 upon 4, because in the fraction the numerator tells us how many parts we have selected, and the denominator tells that how many equal parts are there. Okay. Similarly, in the third one, the circle is divided into 6 parts. So in the denominator we will write 6, and for the numerator we will write 3, as 3 parts are shaded. So we have selected 3 parts, for that the numerator will be 3. In the last one, the circle is divided into 4 parts. Okay students, this is divided into 8 parts. Okay, so to write the fraction, we write 8 in the numerator or denominator. Just think about this. Yes, in the denominator we will write 8, as there are total 8 parts, but in the numerator we will write 4, because 4 parts are shaded or in the blue color. In this way we can represent the fractions according to some given geometrical shapes and their relevant parts. Finally, all these fractions are equivalent. Okay, later I tell you what are equivalent fractions. So come to the next slide. Again here are some pictures and some parts which are shaded. Okay, it's also quite easier. So for the first figure, we just find the fraction of the unshaded parts. Okay, see, in the first square there are total 16 smaller squares, and if we count the number of shaded and the white squares and to write the fraction, so the number of total squares are 16, as very smaller squares, and how many white colored squares are there? They are 4, as you can count from the given figure. So the number of white squares in the form of fraction are 4 upon 16. For the second figure, how many parts are there? There are total 12 parts, so we will write 12 in the denominator and think about the white colored boxes. So, there are 1, 2, 3 and 4, okay, it is 4. So, for the white colored boxes, the fraction is 4 upon 12. Okay. Now, for the next one, you will do and understand both these fractions, then you will do solve the third one by yourself. Come to the next point, simplest form. A fraction is said to be in simplest form if numerator and denominator have no common factor other than 1. I explain it again. So, listen, a fraction is said to be in simplest form if numerator and denominator have no common factor other than 1. Suppose I write a fraction, for example, 3 upon 6, okay, no problem, 3 upon 6, but think about the numbers, if they have some common factor, it means if they are divided by any other number. So, in other words, I can say that if there is another number in the table of that number, both these appears. As you know, in the table of 3, both the number comes. So, we can divide both these numbers by 3. So, you can write 3 divided by 1 upon 6 divided by, sorry, it is 3 divided by 3. So, we write 3 divided by 3 and 6 also divided by 3, because both the numbers come in the table of 3, and finally, the answer will be 1 upon 2. Hence, 3 upon 6 can be also written as 1 upon 2. These are called equivalent fractions. For your help, I have given few other examples. Okay. Reduce the following into simple form or simple fractions. So, first is 48 upon 60. In the next slide, I have solved this 48 upon 60. Okay. Just think about any number that can divide both these numbers. So, you might be thinking that 2, it is 3, okay, no problem, you can start by 2, but if you know that both are divisible by 12 as they appear in the table of 12. So, we write in this way, this is the proper way to find the fraction in a simplest form. We write 48 divided by 12 upon 60 divided by 12. Here, you will divide both the numbers by a same number, means 12 and 12 on both the sides. So, for the numerator, you will divide by 12, for the denominator also you will divide by 12. Finally, in the numerator you get 4 and in denominator you will get 5. So, for this fraction, 4 upon 5 is in the simplest form. Next question is 150 upon 60. As you can see, 0 can be cancelled with each other. Then we have 15 upon 6. Again, this 15 upon 6 can be divided by 3, as these are the multiples and comes in the table of 3. So, we will write 15 divided by 3 upon 6 divided by 3. Finally, we have 5 upon 2. Okay. It means the simplest form of 150 upon 60 is 5 upon 2, and conversely, we can say that both are the equivalent fractions of each other. Okay. Now, for the equivalent fraction, I cover this topic after few time in the next slides. Come to the another topic, that is 250 upon 400. Again, 0 can be cancelled out. So, it becomes 20 upon 25 upon 40. Now, think about both the numbers 25 upon 40. They can be divided by 5. So, we will write 25 divided by 5 and 40 divided by 5. Remember and do very carefully, both these should be same, means the numerator and denominator should be divided by the same number. So, 25 is divided by 5 and 40 is also divided by 5. Finally, you get the answer, that is 5.8. Again, 250 upon 400 and 5.8, both these are equivalent fractions to each other, but 5 upon 8 is the simplest form of 250 upon 400. Okay. Ultimately, the equivalent fractions and the simplest form are connected to each other. Next one, it's about the equivalent fractions. Okay. According to definition, to find equivalent fraction, we divide numerator and denominator by the same number. Here you can multiply also. So, both are correct. Now, I have given an example. So, to find the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 5, what we have to do? This fraction can be multiplied by the same number on the numerator and denominator side. So, you just do in a simpler way, actually it is very easy, you do not need to think much. 2 upon 5 multiplied by 2 upon 2. Why I have written 2 upon 2? As this quantity is 1, nothing else. So, we are dividing or we are multiplying by 1 only. Now, take 2 upon 2, then multiply this 2 by 2 gives 4 and this 5 by 2 gives 10. So, the equivalent fraction is 4 upon 10. Next one, we are taking 2 upon 5. Another equivalent fraction is multiply this by 5 upon 5. Okay. You can take any other number like 7 upon 7, 6 upon 6, all these will give the equivalent fraction. Here 2 5s are 10 and 5 5s are 25 and we are getting the equivalent fraction. So, for your help, I solve this question by taking some other values. As we are finding the equivalent fraction of 2 upon 5. So, think a natural number like 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on, any other number. It does not matter the number is smaller or bigger. You can also think about 100 and do the calculation this way, and you will write 100 to ja 200 and 100 5 ja 500. This is also the equivalent fraction of this. So, in this way you can do multiply or division. Now, revise few important topics. Again, as in the diagram, if want to find out the fraction for the shaded portion, okay, just see how many shaded portions are there. For example, I take a random picture, for example, the third one. So, count the total number of parts which are equal. As you know, the circle is divided into 6 equal parts, write 6 as the denominator. Then, how many shaded parts are there? As 3 parts are there. So, this is the fraction for the shaded parts which are in blue color. Now, for the third circle, the fraction of shaded part is 3 upon 6. Similarly, for the fourth figure, total number of parts are 8, as you can count. Okay. Just we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, no problem, 8 parts are there. And how many shaded parts are there? These are 4. So, for the shaded part, the fraction is 4 upon 8. In this slide, we will follow the same pattern. as in the previous slide. So, if we want to find the fraction for the white colored boxes, again follow the same procedure, find the total number of squares as there are 16, then find the total number of white colored squares, these are 4. So, the fraction for the unshaded squares are 4/16. I hope you are getting it and quite easier. Now, there is a rule for the simplest form. Again revise this topic. A fraction is said to be in simplest form if numerator and denominator have no common factor other than 1. As I solve this one, again I take some other fraction. For example, if a fraction is 2/5, can you think a number which can divide both these? Obviously, no, there is not a number, but 1 is always there. So, there should not be any common factor other than 1. Now, 2/5 is already in the simplest form. We do not need to convert this in simplest form, it is already. But suppose I have written 10/20. As you know, it is not in simplest form. Easily you can cut the zeros and will get 1/2, okay, not a problem. But if zeros are not there, what you will do? For example, suppose there is 25/30. Now, you can think a number which can divide both these. So, in the table of 5, both the numbers come. You can write in this way, 25/5/30/5, okay. Ultimately, we have 5/6. So, the simplest form is 5/6, and the numbers are bigger or smaller does not matter, you just need to find a number which can divide both the numerator and denominator. If you cannot find or you are not able to find, okay, and maybe that you are correct or there is no other number which can divide both the numbers, they are already in the simplest form. Sometimes it happens actually. Now, reduce the following into simplest form. As you can see, if zeros are there, just cut the zeros, then the numbers will be converted into smaller values. So, for your help, I have solved these examples, this one and this one. As you can see, first fraction is 250/400. You might be thinking that there are very bigger values, but do not worry, we will try to divide them by another number. So, we will cut the zeros. Now, it becomes simpler, only we have 25 and 40. If you remember the tables, actually the tables in mathematics will help you to solve different types of problems in different topics. So, we will divide both by 5 and we get 5/8. This is the simplest form of the given fraction, okay. Now, for equivalent fraction, if you want to find equivalent fraction for a given fraction, then you can divide or multiply by a number. For example, here 2/5 is multiplied by 2/2 here, and in second one 2/5 is multiplied by 5/5. As I told you, you can consider other numbers, maybe 1000, maybe 10,000 or maybe 1 crore, does not matter. So, the fractions may be bigger or smaller depending on the numerator and denominator, but the value of that fraction will be equal, okay. So, I hope you have seen all these slides very carefully and memorize the concept it will help you, and in the doubt section you can ask your doubts and solve the questions very carefully as given in the assignments. Okay, have a good day.